Bonjour. Aujourd'hui, on commence avec vous la classe inversée pour la sixième année. Flipped class, just to help you to understand what did you learn during last week. On commence, we start. Lexique et dictée. Vocab and dictation. Un peintre, le mur, le papier, la toile, le collage, le pastel, la peinture à l'huile, un dessin, un conseil, une invitation, regarder, venir, mettre, déjà, jamais, une fourmi, une exposition, quelque chose, un camarade, vu, voir, préparer, poser, commencer. Dictée, le peintre a utilisé une toile et de l'huile. De la grammaire, l'impératif. L'impératif. How can you give order to someone? L'impératif, c'est quoi? L'impératif, c'est le verbe conjugué avec tu ou nous ou vous, mais sans sujet. It means that you have to get the ending in the end of the verb with tu or nous or vous, according to whom to talk. Exemple. When I say regard, mean watch. Regardons ou regardez. Lock the end of the verb e if you want to talk to someone like your friend or your brother, little brother. Regardons ou un s, it means that the verb with nous. We all, we have to do something. Regardez, the verb end by ez, it means that this verb with which pronoun with vous, you all. When you talk to a group or to talk to someone older than you, to respect him, like your father, your mother, like your teacher, etc. Another example, fini, finissons, finissez. Here, first end by s, it means that this verb was tu, when you talk to someone younger than you, or like you, as your friend, your brother. Finissons, end by on s, this verb with nous, when we are group and we have to do something together. So, we put on s in the end of the verb. Ez, finissez, end by ez, when you talk to group or someone older than you, finissez. Finish. Viens, venons, venez, mean come. First one, when you talk to someone younger than you, viens, come. Venons, we have all to come. Venez, it means that come when you talk to group or someone older than you for respect. Mais, mettons, mettez, mais mean to put or to wear clothes. For example, if you want to order your brother, little brother, to put something there, you can say me, first one end by s. Or wear, 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 like pantalon, etc. All these verbs related to regarder, infinitive to watch. Finir, to finish, venir, to come, mettre, to put or to wear. Now, we have come practice. You have it, quête activité, page 40. Choisissez, choose between regarde, if you talk to someone younger than you, or your brother, or your sister, or your friend. Regardez, end by EZ. Watch, but when you talk to group or someone older than you, to respect him, like your teacher, like director, etc. Vient, come, end by S, when you talk to someone younger than you, or your friend, or your brother, etc. Venez, to come, end by Z, use it when you talk to someone older than you, to respect him, or when you talk to group. Me, to put or to wear, when you talk to your brother, or your sister, or your friend, etc. Someone younger than you. Mettons, end by ONS, when you are group and you have to do something together. We start first one. Regard, look here. Monsieur, space, then monsieur. So we talk to someone to respect him. So we have to put in the end OZ. Monsieur, Mister, les posters de Marguerite sont là, à droite. So here we need to put verb end by OZ because we talk to someone to respect him. And the meaning here, watch. Which one mean watch? Which one OZ? The answer, regardez. Second, B. Space, tamponner, il fait froid. Here, the mother talk to son, younger than her. So here with tu, and the meaning mean wear or put. So which one? Me, put or wear. C, space Maggie, les posters de Marguerite sont là à droite. We talk to Maggie as sister, as friend, younger than me. So here, which verb we need? Verb with tu. And the meaning is viens, come. Come, Maggie. Les posters de Marguerite sont là, à droite, in your right hand. D. Space, avec moi, on va visiter l'exposition. Here we talk to group. So we need which verb? End by EZ, as group. So here, venez, come all, come, come all with me to visit l'exposition. E, space, notre poney, elle fait froid. Here, we are group and we have to do something together. So we need which verb end by ONS with nous. Mettons, we bought, we wear, we have to wear notre poney, elle fait froid. F, space, avec moi, with me, on va visiter l'exposition. So here, we talk as friend. As friend, the verb was tu. And I have to put the meaning come. Which verb? Viens, come with me. Okay? C'est compris? Do you understand? We have also in this lesson how can you use form affirmative, form negative. Form affirmative, like déjà, already, before, when we put it in negative, we change it to be jamais, mean never. Again, when we have in the sentence déjà, mean already or before, when we want to use it as form negative, negative form, we have to replace déjà by never in French, mean jamais. Example, je suis déjà allé à Paris. I went before to Paris. When I want to write it negative form, we say, je ne suis jamais allé à Paris. Never. I didn't go to Paris. Here, the verb, you write it between ne and jamais. Ne and jamais. Ne and jamais. How can we use it? Use it comme dialogue, because we have to use grammar when we talk, not grammar to write only no. We have to use it when we talk. Example, est-ce que tu es déjà allé en France? Someone asks you, did you go to France before? You have to say, if no, say what? No, je ne suis jamais allé à Paris ou en France. Okay? Second one, complete the question. And the answer is, non, je n'ai jamais vu de Lyon. I didn't see, never, I didn't see Lyon. So, the question is what? Est-ce que tu as déjà vu un lion? Est-ce que tu as déjà vu un lion? Did you see before lion? Look here, instead of jamais, we write up déjà. So, affirmative. Déjà, négative, the verb between ne, jamais. In your CAD activity also, exercise, you have to answer or put the question according to what you have. First, you have question. So you have to rearrange the answer in your right hand here and write the answer. Est-ce que tu es déjà allé à Madrid? The answer, how can we rearrange it to obtain the good sentence? We say, non, je ne suis jamais allé à Madrid. Second one, you have to write the answer. Est-ce que tu as déjà mangé des escargots? Non or oui? Here you have to say oui and use déjà. Oui, j'ai déjà mangé des escargots. Last one, you have to write the question because you have the answer. Oui, j'ai déjà eu la varicelle. Varicelle. Here you write, est-ce que tu as déjà eu la varicelle? La varicelle. C'est compris? So here, a summary. When we use déjà, we use it affirmative. When we put it negative, we change it to be jamais. Jamais. Merci. À la prochaine.